Hello, spider peeps. All right, this is another mailbag video, sorry, but it's just one thing, and I'm excited about this because it's something I kickstarted. And look, if you buy something from my Etsy shop, I try and send you in these exciting, happy, shiny packages. Super happy fun jiffy bag. Let's have a look what it is. Excuse the fans going in the background. My bamboo is just finishing printing. Here we go then. Yes! I thought it was this, but I had a little bit of doubt. Oh, that's a different one. I'd lost this for ages. All right, so this is something that if you watch Jeff Geerling, he spoke about, and actually ordered it off the back of one of his videos. Well, I didn't order it, I did it on Kickstarter. I didn't order this early on in the Kickstarter campaign. I think I was a bit into it and I don't remember doing an early bird. This has come really quick. I was expecting it sometime later in the year, actually. Yeah, it's a KVM, so it allows you to remote control a computer from anywhere, which of course you can do using things like VNC, but this is lovely. Look at all this peeling that to be done. Yeah, but this is a bit different because it lives outside the computer, so if the computer crashes you should be able to reset it. Probably not going to be the way I use it. I'm going to be able to reset it because at the moment I think I'm going to put this on a Mac Mini that I've got in my network rack. But yeah, you see what's in it. So we've got a network port, we've got like an RJ11 port, we've got USB-C, and we've got probably an HDMI port. All right, so getting started. So this is nice cardboard box, big fish, little fish. I was going to say it's all card, but a bit of expanded foam in there, that nice feeling foam, probably PVC stuff. All right, so we've got some instructions here that are hidden under there. So some instructions there, and what else do I get with it? I think I might have qualified for some stretch goals on this, but I definitely didn't order anything else. So we've got a USB, I assume, power cable. Oh, we've got a lovely looking USB splitter. That's nice. Never seen one of those. USB-C splitter, and then a HDMI cable. JetKVM.com. I assume at some point they will release this so that you can buy it outside of the Kickstarter. All right, so this is, it's pretty heavy. I think they said that the case was zinc. It does feel quality, and actually to feel so heavy for the price I paid is pretty good. And the paint job is beautiful. I know that's got film over it, but yeah, quite beautiful there. Screen's nice as well. Looks like an old type of phone screen. All right, let's power it up and see what we get. Oh, did you see that? I wonder if I can get it to do that again. Looks like a little burst of static when it booted, maybe not the second time. All right, nice screen. I can't remember whether it's touchscreen or not. All right, yeah, no network, connect Ethernet cable. Oh yeah, it is touchscreen. Lovely, wow. Quite good for what you're getting that about. Yeah, status, device ID and cloud account ID. All right, I probably better not show those. All right, so, and then, oh, we've got some stuff there now. We've got HDMI disconnected, USB disconnected, and its MAC address, which I probably ought to blur out as well. I've not got easy access to an Ethernet cable here, and this is going to go somewhere else. So I'm going to go and fit it up where it's got to go, and then we'll see where we go from there. Okay, so here's a place that you haven't seen before. This is my network cabinet, and I'm inside it. Yeah, so I think maybe I'll put the KVM there. Actually,
Actually, I might put it there and print out the little bracket that somebody designed for it. So anyway, let's get this plugged in. So I need my network. I do have a PoE switch here, but at the moment this is just going to have to go wherever it goes. So this doesn't work on PoE, I don't think. So I'm just going to use one of my spare ports on this switch. So now I've got this cable, which is the graphics HDMI. So this here is my Mac Mini. So this should have HDMI out. I hope it does. So let's pop that in there. I think that's the HDMI connector. So at the moment, this always runs headless. And I just do the remote Apple VNC into it. So that needs to go also into the back of this, into the small HDMI, which is there, I think. Yeah, that looks right. Still not lit up. So let's get some power now. Where to get the power from? Obviously, if I get the power from the Mac Mini, if the Mac Mini goes off, then the power to this goes off. So I'm wondering whether to take my power from one of my Raspberry Pis. I think for the moment, let's just take it from the Mac Mini while we're just experimenting. That's the easiest, I think. So let's get my KVM and plug it in. I should get some power now. Yep. So that starts up. And that's going to live there when the cable's printed out. So I'll let that start up. It tells me my IP number. So let's connect to that on a machine elsewhere. That's 139.
Okay, so I'm back at the desk now. So this is all plugged in on the frame. And I've gone to my web browser and gone to the IP address that was shown on the front of it. So it's got this rather nice looking screen. Look, it's bouncing up and down. All right, set up your JetKVM. All right, so there's a password protected mode, which is probably safer, and no password. I tell you what, just for this, I'm going to go down the no password route because it says you can change it afterwards. So let's go no password, continue, see what happens. All right, no HDMI signal detected. Ensure the cable is securely connected at both ends. Well, I did try to do it, didn't I? Well, it said it's connected. It says the USB is connected, but the source device, is it powered on? Let's just go and make sure that that device is woken up, I think, and let's see whether something happens. Okay, so ironically, it was asleep, which is a bit which is a bit annoying. Oh, and it's gone back to sleep again. All right, interesting. Okay, so let's say virtual keyboard. If I type something, there we go. So if I type something, it wakes up again. So it had just gone to sleep, so the HDMI had turned off. All right, so let's type something into it. Can I, if I hide that keyboard, can I type directly into there? Yeah. Okay, so that's worked. I wasn't sure whether it was going to work because I had this feeling that I needed to plug another USB device in, but it seems that the fact that I've just plugged the USB in to get the power from it also means that it's got a keyboard access to it. So obviously the keyboard works, the mouse works, and can we get to YouTube? I mean, getting to YouTube is all about whether it's on the internet. So the thing is, this doesn't need to be on the internet. Because I'm remote controlling the machine from the outside. So interesting. Yeah, so if I go to YouTube. Yeah, so we see it's working, don't we? .com/Spidermaf. Okay. Excellent. All right, so I mean, this is pretty responsive. I mean, look how quick the mouse pointer catches up with me, and it actually feels like I'm using that as a machine. Is there a full screen mode? I don't like full screen mode on things like this because I tend to make it go on full screen and then I can't, over there, and then I can never turn it off. Let's give it a go. Wow, now this looks like I'm using the machine now. That's pretty cool. So it's obviously not using any of the machine's resources for this because this is just the JetKVM on the outside looking in. I didn't see how to turn it off though either, which is a bit worrying. I'm just on Firefox, aren't I? Yeah, so that's fine. So this is JetKVM. Pretty cool little device, and it actually worked pretty much quickly out the box, didn't it? But what did you think? That was pretty quick, wasn't it? So I'm happy I supported this on Kickstarter, and I'm going to look forward to using this. So I hope you found this a little bit interesting. Anyway, if you didn't, watch out for the next video. I'll probably be talking about something completely different. Bye. Getting started. Is there anything in here? Oh, spoilt it.